Hi guys and gals, and welcome to my Aquatic Wild activity, Fashion a Fish. I hope you're excited because we're about to have lots of fun and learn a lot as well. Let's dive right in. Okay, so to begin, we're gonna describe adaptations of fish to their environments. Next, we're gonna describe how these adaptations can help fish survive within their habitat. And lastly, we're going to interpret the importance of adaptations in all animals. So here are some terms to know. The first term is adaptation. It's an alteration or adjustment in structure or habits by which a species or individual improves its condition in relationship to its environment. Second, we have coloration. Coloration is genetically controlled pattern or markings that protect an individual organism. Third, we have camouflage. It is a type of coloration or pattern that helps an animal blend into its surroundings. And lastly, we're going to talk about habitat, which is the arrangement of food, water, shelter, cover, and space suitable to an animal's needs. All right, let's get started with coloration. So as you can see, all of the different fish located on the slide have different colorations. So some of the different colorations include mottled, vertical stripes, horizontal stripes, dark upper side, and a lighter belly side. So for the stripes and mottled coloring, these different types of fish can hide within vegetation or above and underneath different types of objects. For a lighter colored bellied fish, the predators can are not able to see it when they're underneath. And then for the dark upper layer fish, the predators above it cannot see it from above. Next, we're gonna move on to reproduction. So the different types of fish located on this slide have different ways of laying their eggs or having live birth. So the different types of reproduction are eggs laying in nests, free-floating eggs that are in massive amounts. We also have eggs that are laid within vegetation. And lastly, we have some fish that also have live birth. Our next type of adaptation is going to be shape. The different types of fish located on this slide have different shapes, which include the torpedo shape, the vertical dish shape, the horizontal shape, the humpback shape, and the flat belly shape. So as you can see here, we have these different types of fish that distinguish these or illustrate these types of adaptations. So for instance, we have a vertical disc fish, which is able to see on different ways above and above different structures. And then we have our torpedo shaped fish, which is able to move very quickly through water. So it's able to escape from predators very fast. So lastly, we're gonna talk about the adaptation of mouth feeding. So we have the fish in our top left corner, which has a sucker-shaped mouth. And this is very helpful for this fish because it is able to collect very small organisms and vegetation. So it's able to get its food with the sucker-shaped mouth by getting very small organisms and vegetation that other fish that have larger mouths are not able to get quite as easily. We also have largemouth fish, which they're able to surround their prey very quickly and collect large amounts of food at one time. So they're able to get to food quicker than some other fish because they're able to surround it very easily. So as you can see, these types of fish here on this slide have different types of mouth shapes, which allow them to survive within their habitat. Okay, now for the fun part. So now we're gonna start our activity of fashion a fish. So we're gonna be doing this activity, you can do it by yourself or you can do it in groups of three or four. So no matter if you're alone or with a group of people, you can still do this activity and have lots of fun. So each group is gonna get a set of cards, or if you're an individual, you will just get, pick a card from four different categories of coloration, mouth, body type, and reproduction. So to collect our materials, we're going to start with our flashcards. You're going to have your four different flashcards with your coloration, mouth type, body shape, and reproduction. Next, you're going to get a brown bag. And you may need more than one brown bag, but we can talk about this later at the end of this presentation about why you might want more than one. You'll also need a pair of scissors, a glue stick, and markers, and the different types of eyes. So you can either have smaller eyes or larger eyes, just whatever type you want for your fish. So you'll then create an art form that represents the fish that you have chosen, or the different types of adaptations that you have picked from the separate stack of cards. Then you can name your fish for fun, and then you can also draw habitat for your fish. This is where, when I said you may need more than one brown bag, and it's because you may need to draw a habitat for your fish, and you may need extra room for that. Or if you're drawing your reproduction, you may need more room to draw that in, depending on how you want to design your fish. It's all up to you. You can have so much fun with it. So let's take a look at what I've created with my fashion to fish. So for my first fish, as you can see, I have a vertical dish-shaped fish. So it has eyes on either side of its body. And then we also have a model coloration on my fish. So it's got, you can see the different colors on there. And this helps this fish hide within vegetation or different types of areas above and below objects. So it's helpful with like kind of like a camouflage, and it can help it hide within those vegetative areas. And then next we're going to talk about the type of reproduction this fish has. So as you can see, my fish here has its vegetation, has its eggs on the vegetation. So when it's time for these eggs to hatch, they'll hatch off of this vegetation. So they'll stay stuck there up until the time where they need to hatch. Next, we're going to talk about its mouth and feeding. So my fish has a large jaw, which allows it to surround its prey quicker and collect it and have its meal very quickly. So this is my fish, and I have named my fish here Bob, because I just think that's a really fun name for my fish. And it just has that type of personality. So for my second fish I have here, you can see that its body shape is a torpedo shape. And like we talked about earlier, a torpedo shaped body allows the fish to move very quickly in the water. So it can move fast when a predator is coming, it can move fast and get away. So that's a great adaptation to have for this type of fish. Next, you can tell that its reproduction is located within a nest. So you can see here that our eggs are located in a nest. So it's probably going to be guarding these eggs up until the time that they hatch. Next, we can talk about the coloration of this fish, which it has a darker upper side here. So fish that are above this fish will have a hard time being able to find it because of its dark area up there. So it allows it to be hidden from those fish that are above. And then lastly, we're going to talk about mouth feeding. So as you can see here, it has a sucker mouth, which allows it to get those small organisms and small vegetation that other fish cannot get to. So it's able to get those very small organisms and very small vegetation for its meal, so that it can help it survive within its habitat. And this fish's name is Gloria, because it just has the personality of what seems to be a Gloria. All right, so you've seen my fish. So I would like to see y'all's as well. So have fun with it, be creative. So let's do a review of what we've learned so far today. So we've learned about what an adaptation is, coloration, how the coloration helps the animals or the fish be able to survive within their habitat. And then our camouflage, where they can hide, and then their habitat itself, which will determine how they use their adaptations, the certain adaptations that they have. So how do you think these components will increase an animal's likelihood of survival? Well, we've also talked about that. So like the sucker mouth on the fish, it can get those organisms and vegetation that are very small that others can't get. So if it's in an area or a habitat that has a lot of these small organisms and a lot of the small vegetation, then its likelihood of surviving is much greater than those that aren't able to collect those small organisms. also for our torpedo fish. So it's got a long, slim body, which is makes it able to swim through the fast much quicker. So it's able to both hide and get away pretty fast. So those are different ways that it can increase its likelihood of survival within its habitat. So let's talk about other animals that have different adaptations or unique adaptations that we know of. So when you're thinking of like a unique adaptation, you could think of maybe a giraffe because it has a really long neck and it can reach leaves that are way high up in the tree that other smaller animals can't get to. So its long neck allows it to be able to get that vegetation that's higher up at a higher elevation than the smaller animals can get to. And then also, when you think about a turtle, it has a shell, a protective shell that protects it from when predators come around to attack it or get it. It's able to hide within its shell until it's till the coast is clear, and then it can go out and about within its habitat so that it has a higher rate of survival. So I hope you've learned a lot today. Think about these things when you're thinking about animals you see every day or animals that you've researched or haven't taken a look at. Think about these adaptations and how they're able to survive within their habitat because of these adaptations. So adaptations are very important, and they're a huge part of how an animal survives within its habitat. So thank you for joining me today. I hope you had fun diving down deep with me and learning about the different adaptations of fish, and then also connecting it with other adaptations of other animals. I hope to see you soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.